Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video we will see how we can easily download and install the current Eclipse version, that is 2022-03 version. So to install Eclipse we need Java also, it's a prerequisite. So we will also install the current Java version, that is Java 18. After that we will also see how we can run a sample Java program on Eclipse IDE. So guys, let's begin with the first step, that is to download and install Java 18. Let's begin. At first, go to the browser. I'm using Chrome. You can use any browser. On Google, type Oracle Java. Press Enter. On pressing Enter, you can see the official website is visible, oracle.com. Click on it to open. On opening, on the right itself, on the official website, you can see Download Java. Click on it. After clicking herein, you can see Java 18 is available now. So this is what we want for Windows. I'll go below. Here it is, Java 18. Now Linux, Mac and Windows, for all three platforms the Java 18 version is visible. We want for Windows, I'll click here. On clicking, now you can see three files are visible to download. We will go for the installer x64, that means for 64-bit Windows 10. Click on this file to download. On clicking, the download will start. Herein you can see 153 MB only. Let's wait for a few seconds. So herein guys, you can see we have successfully downloaded the Java 18, the JDK 18 exe file. Remember that for Java we only need JDK now. We don't need to install JRE separately because this installation includes JRE also. So I'll just double click on it to install. Minimize this. Guys, the installation started. Now let us click on next. After clicking next, herein you can see it will create a Java directory in program files and the installation will go inside it. The installation files will go inside it. You can change the location from here, but the default is fine. Click on next. The installation started now. So guys, we have successfully installed it. Click on close. Now let us see wherein we have installed Java. Remember it was in C drive program files. Here is Java. Inside JDK 18, I told you it will get installed here. Now herein go to bin. Right click and copy this path. Now minimize. Go to start. Type environment variables. Herein click on edit the system environment variables. The first one, click on open. Click on environment variables from here. Herein under system variables, the path is visible. We will set the path now. Double click on it. Click on new and just right click and paste the same path. So we pasted the following path. Now guys, click on OK. Now herein I'll also create another path, that is new. That is click on new. This will be Java underscore home path. Herein paste the same variable value, that is the path, but remove the bin here. That's it. Click on OK. We have set two paths. Click on OK and click on the last OK. That's it. So guys, we successfully installed Java 18. Let's see. Go to start. Type cmd. Click on open to open the command prompt. Now we will verify the installation of Java. To verify, type the command java space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. On pressing enter, if the following is visible, that means you have successfully installed the current Java version, that is Java 18 in this case. Now let us close this. Now for the second step, we'll be downloading and installing the current Eclipse version, Eclipse 2022-03. Let's begin. Go to the web browser. I'm using Chrome. You can use any browser. On Google, type Eclipse. Press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible. Click on it. So we have reached the official website, eclipse.org. Click on the download button. Here is the download page for Eclipse. When you'll go below, you can see the 2022-03 Eclipse IDE is visible. And this is available for 64-bit operating system, Windows. Click on download to download it. Now different mirrors are visible. You can directly click here to download it. Now the download should start. The download started. It's only 113 MB. Let's wait for a few seconds. So guys, the download completed. Now let us double click on it to install. Minimize this. Now guys, the Eclipse installer is visible. Here in Eclipse ID for different platforms are visible. Following is for Java. This is for Enterprise Java, C++. Below is Embedded C++. This is for Web Dev, that is PHP development. Okay. Since we want for Java, so I'll directly click on Eclipse ID for Java developers. So herein you can see guys, it automatically took our Java JDK part, which we just installed. That's why Java is required to install Eclipse, I told you before. And this is the installation folder for Eclipse. So after installing, we can find the files here. Eclipse will get installed here. If you want, you can change the location from here, but I guess this is fine. It will create a start menu entry as well as a desktop shortcut for Eclipse, which is fine. Now click on install directly. Now the installation started, you need to wait for a few seconds. User agreement, you can read it here, click on accept now. Now the installation started. The installation is complete. Click on launch to directly launch the Eclipse ID. You can also double click on the desktop shortcut, or you can go to start and you can see here it is visible, or you can type Eclipse here and open the current version from here. We just installed this. I'll directly click on launch here. So herein you can see it is asking for a directory as workspace. So workspace is a place in Eclipse wherein all your project files, folders, resources and plugins will get saved. So whenever you'll create a new project on Eclipse, it will get saved in the following location. You can also change this location, but I'll keep the same and I'll set a default for all the projects so that it won't ask me again and again while creating new projects. Let's click on launch. So here it is guys, it has started for the first time. Now you can directly create a Java project from here, but I'll close this and I'll directly click on file, then new, then a Java project. Let us add the name of the project. I'll add Amit project and location is the same. Herein you can check that our workspace location was the following. I told you all the projects will get saved under the workspace directory. So therefore, our project will also get saved here. Herein you can see you need to select the JRE, that is the JDK we installed. So here it is showing options. I'll just select project specific JRE, that is JDK 18. Rest I'll keep the same. I'll just uncheck this because we are just creating a sample project. Click on next. Now the project will get created. Here it is. Just click on finish. So our project got created guys. Click here, you can see. Now I'll just right click, new, and create a new Java class file to run our first program. Let us add a name. I'll give it demo. Package keep the default, let's say. Rest keep it as it is. I'll select publish static void main directly, and rest keep the default and click on finish. So here it is guys. Let us quickly print something. To print in Java, we use system.out.println. Okay, within that, enter any statement, any line you want to print. Okay, semicolon, do not forget the semicolon, and that's it. Go to file and click on save all. Now you can go to run and run the project by clicking run here, or you can click on run as Java application. I'll click on it. Herein you can see we successfully printed my first Java program here. We used ln for next line. Okay, print ln, but we can also use print here. If you are printing on the next line, then you need ln also. Okay, now I'll again run it. Okay, yes. Now here it is. It went to the next line Amit things because we used ln here. Okay. So guys, in this video we saw how we can easily download and install Eclipse IDE. We installed Java before installing Eclipse because it's a prerequisite. After that, we also ran a sample Java project on Eclipse. So guys, thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, do subscribe to our channel Amit Things.